I will speak about angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor. Angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor. They will end with what? Bril, 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 bril. So captopril, captopril, enalapril, enalapril, lisinopril, lisinopril, ramipril, ramipril. So bril, bril, bril. Bril, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor, ACE inhibitor, ACE inhibitor. So the mechanism is what? Inhibition of ACE. Inhibition of ACE is going to convert angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2. So if there is inhibition of ACE, there is decrease in angiotensin 2. Decrease in angiotensin 2 means what? Angiotensin 2, we have this is the glomerulus afferent and efferent. So angiotensin 2 acting on the efferent arteriole leading to vasoconstriction. Restriction of the efferent arteriole leading to increase the pressure here, increase hydrostatic pressure leading to increase the glomerular filtration rate, increase glomerular filtration rate. So if there is decrease inhibition of ACE leading to decrease angiotensin 2 leading to vasodilatation, dilatation of the efferent arteriole, dilatation of the efferent arteriole leading to decrease the hydrostatic pressure, decrease hydrostatic pressure leading to decrease the glomerular filtration rate, decrease glomerular filtration rate by what? By prevention of constriction of the efferent arteriole. So I will prevent the constriction by what? By decrease the angiotensin 2 leading to dilatation of the efferent arteriole leading to decrease glomerular filtration rate. So this is an inhibitor for RAS. What is RAS? RAS, renin angiotensin aldosterone system. So by prevention of ACE leading to inhibition of angiotensin 2, decrease angiotensin 2 and decrease aldosterone. So if there is elevation of aldosterone, there is what? There is negative feedback on RAS leading to decrease the renin. So if there is no aldosterone, there is loss of negative feedback. No negative feedback means what? Means elevation in renin due to loss of negative feedback, because there is inhibition of this RAS pathway. There is inhibition of angiotensin 2, inhibition of aldosterone, there is no negative feedback leading to elevation of the renin. So inhibition of ACE is also prevents what? Prevents inactivation of bradykinin. This means what? There is elevation, there is accumulation of bradykinin. This is so important because bradykinin has what? Potent vasodilator. It's a potent vasodilator. So accumulation of bradykinin leading to what? Leading to cough and angioedema. It's what? Dry cough and angioedema due to what? Accumulation of bradykinin. So it's contraindicated to use it in what? C1 esterase inhibitor deficiency. So if there is C1 esterase inhibitor deficiency, don't use ACE inhibitor, because ACE inhibitor will lead to accumulation of bradykinin, which is a potent vasodilator leading to angioedema, and of course it will lead to what? Dry cough. So don't use it with C1 esterase inhibitor deficiency. So you will use ACE inhibitor in which case? A clinical use, you will use it in hypertension. Why? Because there is no angiotensin 2. So there is no vasoconstriction, there is dilatation of the blood vessel, plus there is no aldosterone. Aldosterone will do what? Sodium reabsorption, potassium and hydrogen loss. So if there is no aldosterone, there is loss of sodium. So it will cause hypotension as a side effect. So it's used in treatment for what? For hypertension. Then in heart failure decrease mortality. Why? Because there are drugs that will be used in prevention of remodeling of the heart. What are these drugs? We have A, B, and S. A, B, and S. A, S inhibitor ARBs. S and ARBs. B, beta blocker. S, spironolactone. So we have S and ARBs, and we have beta blocker, and spironolactone. Spironolactone, these drugs will be used in case of what? Degrees the remodeling of the heart as a result of chronic hypertension. Degrees the remodeling of the heart in case of chronic hypertension. ACE ARBs, beta blocker, and spironolactone. So heart failure decreases the mortality. Decreases the mortality in case of usage of what? ACE and ARBs and beta blocker and spironolactone. So proteinuria, why? Because there is dilatation. There is dilatation of the efferent arteriole because there is loss. There is no angiotensin II. So there is dilatation of the efferent arteriole leading to decrease the proteinuria. Decrease the filtration. Decrease proteinuria. Then diabetic nephropathy. What is the best way? What is the mechanism of diabetic nephropathy? There is elevation in glomerular filtration rate that will lead to glomerular sclerosis and formation of Kimmel-Steel-Wilson nodule. So by dilatation of the efferent leading to decrease glomerular filtration rate leading to decrease sclerosis in diabetic nephropathy. Then it will prevent the unfavorable heart remodeling with other drugs, ARBs, beta blocker, and spironolactone. Plus, in chronic kidney disease, diabetic nephropathy used in ACE should be used in it. Why? There is dilatation of the efferent arteriole leading to decreased intraglomerular pressure, decreased glomerular filtration rate, decreased sclerosis of the glomeruli, decreased formation of Kimmel-Steel-Wilson nodule, slowing of glomerular basement membrane because there is decrease in glomerular filtration rate by dilatation of the efferent arteriole. So captopril and other adverse effects leading to a cough, angioedema. Why? There is accumulation of bradykinin, so it's a contraindicated in C1 esterase inhibitor deficiency. Then teratogen, it's so important, it's asked in the exam. So ACE inhibitor leading to what? Fetal renal malformation. So fetal means fetus. So there is renal malformation in the fetus. If the mother is using what? ACE inhibitor leading to what? Renal malformation in the fetus. Plus increase in creatinine. Why? Because there is dilatation of the efferent arteriole leading to decrease the hydrostatic pressure in the glomeruli leading to decrease the glomerular filtration rate. Decrease glomerular filtration rate leading to elevation in creatinine. Plus there is loss of what? There is loss of rest system. Why? Because rest, renin angiotensin aldosterone system. So I will give ACE inhibitor that will inhibit conversion of angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2. So there is no angiotensin 2 plus no aldosterone. So aldosterone will do what? Sodium reabsorption, potassium and hydrogen loss. So if there is no aldosterone leading to what? Sodium loss leading to hypotension, plus potassium and hydrogen accumulation in the body. Potassium accumulation leading to hyperkalemia. So it's used with caution in what? Bilateral. It's contraindicated to use it in bilateral. But if it's a unilateral renal artery stenosis, you can use it. But if it's bilateral, it's contraindicated to use it. Why? Because there is dilatation of the efferent arteriole leading to severe decrease in glomerular filtration rate. Because there is loss, there is decrease in hydrostatic pressure leading to decrease glomerular filtration rate leading to renal failure, and there is no blood or decrease in the blood reaching to the kidney. There is decrease in the blood because of stenosis, and it's bilateral. Decrease in the blood reaching to the kidney, plus there is dilatation of the efferent leading to severe decrease in glomerular filtration rate and sudden rise in creatinine because of usage of what? ACE inhibitor and prevention of angiotensin II effect on the efferent arteriole leading to dilatation of the efferent. Then the next one we have what? Angiotensin II receptor blocker. So ARBs, sartan, so luzartan, candy, zartan, valsartan, so ARBs, mechanism, it will block what? Block the effect of angiotensin 2 on angiotensin 2 receptor, so prevention of action of angiotensin 2 on its receptor, so selectively block binding of angiotensin 2 with its its receptor. So it's like ACE inhibitor, but it's so important. It's so important. Why? Because there is no elevation of bradykinin in case of ARBs. No elevation of bradykinin in case of ARBs. So if the patient is suffering from elevation of bradykinin, the risk of angioedema and cough with the patient taking ACE inhibitor, you must shift from ACE inhibitor to ARBs. To ARBs, why? Because there is no accumulation in bradykinin with ARBs. No accumulation of bradykinin with ARBs. So dry cough and angioedema because of elevation in bradykinin in case of what? In case of ACE inhibitor. ACE inhibitor. So don't use it with C1 esterase inhibitor deficiency. But here, if the patient is taking ACE and suffering from these side effects of ACE, you must shift to what? ARBs, ARBs, ARBs. Why? Because there is no accumulation of bradykinin. So no cough, no angioedema, like what? Like ACE inhibitor. So no cough, no angioedema. So if there is intolerance to ACE inhibitor, because of what? Because of its side effects, cough and angioedema, you must shift to what? ARBs, because there is no accumulation of bradykinin, no cough, no angioedema in case of ARBs. In cases of ARBs, then it's used in case of what? Hypertension. Why? Because there is no angiotensin II effect on its receptor. So there is what? There is loss of vasoconstriction leading to vasodilatation, leading to degrees the blood pressure. Plus angiotensin II will not stimulate the glomerulosa of the adrenal cortex to release the aldosterone. So there is no aldosterone. So leading to what? Leading to sodium loss and accumulation of potassium and hydrogen. So accumulation of potassium leading to hyperkalemia, sodium loss leading to hypotension. Plus it's a teratogen like ACE inhibitor. So ACE inhibitor, like what? ARBs in teratogenicity. But the most important is what? Is ACE regarding fetal renal malformation. It's asked in the exam, fetal renal malformation. Plus there is decrease in glomerular filtration rate because there is vasodilatation of the efferent arteriole leading to decrease the glomerular filtration rate. So it's used in what? In case of hypertension, because there is no effect of angiotensin II leading to vasodilatation of blood vessel. Plus there is decrease in aldosterone leading to sodium loss, leading to decrease the blood pressure. Plus heart failure, because there is it's one of the drugs that's used in case of what? Remodeling, inhibition of remodeling. So we have ACE and ARBs, B beta blocker, S spironolactone. So ACE and ARBs leading to inhibition of remodeling of the heart. So brutinuria, why there is dilatation of the efferent leading to decrease the risk of brutinuria. Then chronic kidney disease, diabetic nephropathy, why? Because there is dilatation of the efferent leading to decrease the pressure, decrease hydrostatic pressure, decrease the glomerular filtration rate, decrease sclerosis with diabetes, decrease the risk of formation of Kimmel-Steel-Wilson nodule. This is used in case of what? If there is intolerance to ACE inhibitor. So you will use ACE inhibitor at the beginning, but if there is intolerance to ACE inhibitor because of cough and angioedema, so you will use the alternative for it, which is ARBs, because there is no elevation in bradykinin, no cough or angioedema. Then aliskiren is used, it's what? It's a direct renin inhibitor leading to blockage of what? Of conversion of angiotensinogen into angiotensin 1. So there is rest system, renin angiotensin aldosterone system, and this is direct renin inhibitor leading to decrease the conversion of angiotensinogen into angiotensin 1, decrease the conversion of angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2, decrease the complete pathway, decrease angiotensin 2, decrease the aldosterone. So it will suppress the rest system because it's inhibitor for the renin, leading to inhibition of RAS, inhibition of renin angiotensin aldosterone system. So it's used in case of what? Hypertension, because there is loss loss decrease in angiotensin 2 leading to vasodilation plus aldosterone. There is loss of aldosterone, loss of sodium, and keeping potassium and hydrogen in the body. Loss of sodium leading to decrease the blood pressure, so it's used in hypertension. So it can use also what? It can cause adverse effects like what? Hypotension, because there is sodium loss. And it will cause hyperkalemia because there is loss of aldosterone leading to decreased sodium reabsorption leading to what? Hypotension plus accumulation of potassium and hydrogen leading to hyperkalemia because of accumulation of potassium, and decrease the glomerular filtration rate. Why? Because there is no angiotensin 2 leading to dilatation of the efferent leading to decrease the glomerular filtration rate. Plus it will cause what? Angioedema. Like what? Like ACE inhibitor. So the only one you can use in cases of cough and angioedema is what? ARBs, because ACE plus L-skyrin, both of them will cause cough and angioedema. So you must use what? ARBs in case of cough and angioedema. Then relatively contraindicated in patients taking what? ACE inhibitor and ARBs. Why? Because it's not logic. Why? Because all will work on RAS system. So don't use many drugs with each other with the same function on RAS. So L-skyrin will inhibit the RAS. ACE inhibitor will inhibit the RAS. ARBs will inhibit the RAS. So don't use L-skyrin with other drugs that will inhibit the same pathway. Plus, it's contraindicated in pregnancy. So L-skyrin, it's contraindicated in pregnancy. Plus, don't use it with ACE or ARBs. Don't use it with ACE or ARBs. And it's contraindicated in case of what? In case of pregnancy. This is L-skyrin.